Tim Wilhelm here from the Kankakee Community College IREC accredited solar training program. One important element in the world of solar technology is being able to do a proper site assessment for a solar install. A component and a necessary task within that site assessment is doing a proper shade analysis. The big go-to tool for shade analysis is the Solar Pathfinder tool. One thing we need to do with the Solar Pathfinder is not only level it, we also have to orient it to true south. Now, the old-fashioned way of finding true north and true south was to shoot the North Star. You take a transit outside in the middle of the night, you aim the transit right up the star Polaris, you leave it, you come back the next morning, bring the transit down, and you have a true north-south line. Very inconvenient and very impossible on a cloudy night. So we have to go to a more convenient, simple way of acquiring true south. To do that, standard technique for centuries has been the magnetic compass. There's a problem with that though. The magnetic compass points to magnetic south and not to true south. Charles Hapgood, multiple decades ago, wrote a book called The Path of the Pole, in which he described how the magnetic north pole of the Earth wanders around on the surface of the planet, or it emits its flux from the surface of the planet at different points, rarely if ever aligning with true north or true south. So we need to be able to adjust from the direction given to us by our magnetic compass and adjust it to the true polar axis of the Earth. Let's look at what that means. So before we make this adjustment, let's first discuss a little terminology. I want to talk about the magnetic poles on the Earth. Two ways we could say this. We could talk about magnetic north, or we could talk about the north magnetic pole. I want to make a clear distinction here because science says that the magnetic pole here in the northern half of the Earth is actually a magnetic south pole. Magnetic south pole at the north pole of the Earth, that starts to get confusing. I'm going to try to simplify this, and instead of using the phrase magnetic north or magnetic south, I'm going to use north magnetic pole, implying that whatever the true magnetic polarity of this is, be it north or south, when I say north magnetic pole, I'm talking about the magnetic pole up near the true north pole of the Earth. And when I say south magnetic pole, I'm talking about the magnetic pole at the southern end of the Earth, as opposed to magnetic south up here and magnetic north down there. Now that that's clarified, a few other little things to keep in mind. One is that because the geographic north pole and the geographic south pole are the ends of the axis of the Earth's rotation, we can fairly assume that they're exactly 180 degrees opposite one another. So when we make this adjustment we're talking about for magnetic declination, we are identifying true geographic north. We can assume that true geographic south is going to be 180 degrees down. So now let's look at what we've got here. Right here I have the true geographic north pole of the Earth, and currently right about in this neck of the woods is where the north magnetic pole of the Earth is. It is there now. It does wander around on the planet, but right now it's right about here. And if I line these two like this, you can see that they come down right near the Mississippi River. They're lined up right near the Mississippi River, and this line has a special name, where the north magnetic pole is aligned with the geographic north pole. This is called the agonic line, and at the agonic line, we have a declination, a magnetic declination of 0 degrees. Now, how do we transition from the agonic line to having this thing that we call declination? I'm going to show you right now. As I move off, where I'm pinching is my physical position on the planet. Notice I have an angular difference as I move around on the planet. I have an angular difference between where the compass is pointing toward that north magnetic pole and where I should be looking to true north, true geographic north. The magnetic declination is this angular difference. Another important distinction here is notice that when I'm over here west of the Mississippi River, the compass line is rotated clockwise from the line to true north. Because it's rotated clockwise away, this would be called a positive declination. As I move over here to the east, notice that the compass line toward the north magnetic pole is rotated counterclockwise from the line to true north. Therefore, this is would be what we would call a negative declination. I want you to see also that declination angle changes as I move from north to south. That angle also changes that way. So this is a very simple explanation of what magnetic declination is. One small fine point that might not be totally important at this point, but I want to be accurate here. The compass needle itself is a magnet, and it rides along the lines of the magnetic flux. And the flux is not a perfectly poker straight line. It is sort of a wonky line, and so a needle here would be pointing that way, a needle there pointed that way. This is why we use maps from the U.S. Geologic Survey, from the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, from websites like www.magnetic-declination.com, because you can pick a location on the planet and it will give you exactly what the declination is at this point, and that makes the wonky line irrelevant because you read off of there what your declination is and it tells you exactly how much you need to adjust your instrument. Let's go ahead and look at the Pathfinder now. Now that we've looked up from USGS data sources what the magnetic declination is at our location, before we do our shade analysis with the Pathfinder, we need to make an adjustment for that magnetic declination. To do that, remove the dome off the top, and now what we have here is a little white dot right at the top of the ring here, and you'll notice this scale of angles that goes negative over this way and positive over this way. And right now, that white dot is lined up with 0 degrees. This would be great if we were over along the Mississippi River on the Agonic line. However, here in Kankakee, Illinois, we have a magnetic declination of about -3 degrees. Now remember, that means that magnetic north is rotated counterclockwise from true north. So what we have to do is we have to move this clockwise, that 3 degrees, to compensate for that. So I'm going to rotate clockwise 3 degrees, and now I'm lined up on the -3 degree mark to match the declination that we have. If I was in Northern California, the declination there is more severe. And in Northern California, it actually is starting to approach a positive 10 degrees. Remember that positive declination said that magnetic north was rotated clockwise away from true north. So to adjust for that, I want to turn this counterclockwise to almost 10 degrees. Notice it's a positive declination adjustment now. Once that's done, I can put my dome back on the Pathfinder, and with the dome back on the Pathfinder, I can again level this, orient the needle to magnetic south, and I will know that my chart has been oriented to true south, and I can get a good, solid reading of what my shading is, and I can more accurately estimate what my performance will be over the course of the year. That's how you do it. For more information, please log in to www.kcc.edu/res, Renewable Energy Stuff. Look for our YouTube channel there, link to it, and subscribe to it, and you'll be updated on further instructional videos as they become available. Have a great day.